Which you did?
Yeah.
Okay, which one's mine? This one? This one. How do I see the live story?
It's not live.
It will come here, no?
Yeah.
Wait, you don't want
it? No, you didn't.
I said I didn't. Yeah, I'll give it to you. Perfect.
You want me to go live over here as well?
Yeah, or you can just put it out there so they can... You know what? It'll be easier so that you don't have to...
No, I'm going on Facebook.
Insta.
Let everybody enjoy. It's okay, we both.
But what he'll say, no?
Hey, no? Yeah, perfect.
Badhiya hai.
Or you can keep it vertical also, no?
Vertical on Insta.
On Insta will not work, no?
It will not work.
Ah, that's right.
Yeah.
I can't see.
This whole
parenting mom space is so huge.
Yeah,
it's so really big. And we were just doing, I told you before, this baby, we lose you on this camera.
So they can't go, either he can just put the phone aside, like tilt it towards TJ and me.
TJ and him.
Yeah. Perfect. Yeah. Are you okay with this?
No? Yeah, I'm okay.
Both. Yeah, both of you together.
Yeah. Perfect. Why is the face elongated? In the...
In what?
He feels his face is looking too long. It's an actor thing.
Nice, nice.
Can you move
over there?
Yeah,
it's
long.
It's not fine. Is this your
iPhone?
Can we put it
outside?
Yeah, sure.
So like you don't have space to walk. Just keep it here.
Are we already live? No.
Last time,
like last time, a white screen and then...
You'll get a proper countdown. You'll get a proper countdown.
Last time, you'll get a proper countdown.
And ask any questions out there so I can answer all your questions on my FB live, Karanveer or fan page.
I can't get up also because the bike is lying down somewhere.
Okay.
Ready? Oh, it's okay.
No, it's just preview right now. Just when you're ready, it's...
Oh, you've not given me that iPad.
Oh, you'll get a question here.
I'll get it there?
Yeah.
If you don't want to answer, I'll answer
still. No, then I'll hold the Insta thing, no?
Yeah. I'll get it there, Pakka. Yeah, yeah. If it doesn't appear,
keep
then
it
this is
the iPad. Keep the iPad over there. Just pick it up whenever you
want. If then the camera is there, then I'll pick up.
Don't
worry.
I've
learned the tricks.
I'm answering questions with my glasses on.
You look good. Cool.
Sorry, half.
I wish all of us could wear glasses. Nobody will come to know
we are so.
Very half.
Search on the page.
No, it's okay. I'm actually really fine with answering with my normal eyes.
Teja looks fine in whatever she wears.
I always have an issue with people just show wearing glasses. Like, are you trying to be inconspicuous because you stand out even more?
Maybe I'm like
a foolish person inside wearing glasses?
I'm not trying to be inconspicuous. I'm trying to be invisible.
Oh, Okay.
Like drags.
Yeah, yeah, you're very invisible in glasses.
Got it, yeah.
Okay, so halfway I will leave the music.
Once it's live, it'll appear.
It's not coming, but
I like a chain queen, queen that y'all have wearing.
It's such a coincidence, I didn't realize.
Oh, what is it?
What? You want to see it? I didn't know.
What about this?
Yeah. What? No! If you would be coordinated, I would be wearing blue jeans as well.
I know, I thought it was coordinated. That's no. Why I like the way you're wearing.
This is unbelievable.
I take a picture.
Yeah, this is unbelievable.
This is twins thing too, seriously.
Oh god, this is such a coincidence.
Oh god.
If you know what I mean. Yeah, really, that's strange. It's unbelievable.
DJ.
Wow. How did you notice that?
Yeah, how did anybody notice?
She could have, because we don't have eyes looking at us, no?
Okay,
yes. Are you ready?
Yes, we are ready to roll.
Ready!
Roll master.
My goodness, I cake. Do we have a back race?
There's no back race. Yeah.
Oh,
it's a little bit. It's a
Hey, we have to leave it.
Yeah, yeah.
15 minutes.
Yeah, we'll just finish it.
We'll wrap it up too far, like a buzzer round. Then all your questions will be like a buzzer round.
Sweetie, don't put pressure on. They also have
somebody coming in. I've forgotten everything. I've forgotten it.
Roll camera.
That's how we just go.
Yeah. Roll, Aja.
Roll, Aja. Like, kind of.
Slump it.
Aja, rolling.
She's cold. Rolling, rolling. Just like a normal.
Warm it up.
Look for the countdown.
Okay, watch for the countdown.
Okay, yeah.
The moment the countdown comes here.
Okay, I'm going to hit live.
Hey, gently. Don't hurt it.
Where's the countdown?
Did you hit it? You didn't hit it.
Yup.
There it is.
Ready.
7, 6, 9.
4, 3. 2, 1. Woo! Bingo!
Hi everyone, we are coming to you live from the Facebook Mumbai studios, and we have with us a celeb couple who are really showing India what equal parenting is all about. Karanveer and TJ, welcome to Mom Espresso and Facebook India office.
Oh my god, that was like completely rehearsed.
It was
Word by word.
Yeah, that
wow.
Okay.
Good job. Thank you so much for having us. Yeah. Thank you, Facebook, for having us.
Yeah. We love being here.
I know. I think I'm going to have like a small little corner of mine here, if you guys don't mind, Facebook.
Yeah. Okay. Let's get on with
what we're
here for.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah. We are here to talk about equal parenting and, we are here to talk about equal parenting and Father's Day is ahead of us, Karanveer. And we have been hearing a lot of these terms, millennial dads, you know, hands-on dads, millennial parents, reading about them as well, but rarely do we see somebody, you know, practicing it in, you know, in their lives, and that's true, somebody who's in the limelight. And you have been really like setting example for millennial dads. What do you have to say about that?
I've put the light away.
Okay.
And I'm just bringing lime juice every day. So that's the limelight I'm in right now. I'm in the lime of my career. Not the prime of my career. I'm in the lime of my career right now. Okay. Because this is the only time where you get to spend the best years of your life with your kids. I'm really glad ki pichle kuch mahino mein I haven't picked up any work. Okay. And I'm just looking at these babies grow. This time won't come back. And I, with God's grace, I have this... He's given me this choice that I can choose not to pick up work. You know, I don't have to be pressured. I don't have to be engineered. Like, you know, you have to, you know, a 9-to-6 job, or like there's a shoot happening that you have to. There's no way you can stop. So I'm really thankful, and I see to that. मैं सारा हाथ बटाऊं मेरी बीवी के साथ तो मैं भी एक क्या कहते हैं एक
आदर्श
आदर्श पति कह रहा हूँ.
And, you know, talking about Adarsh, you know, Pati and a father, you know, we recently did on Mother's Day, we did a Mom's Happiness Index survey on Mom's Presso, which was plus moms taking part in it. And one thing that really stood out was the fact that 70% of Indian moms are unhappy. And happy moms are happy. Yeah, happy moms are happy because 87% of them get the support from their husbands in raising kids together. And we really see Karunveer and TJ, you know, being, you know, doing it together and doing it right, you know. So, TJ, what do you have to say how Karunveer has changed, you know?
Wait, keep that question. Okay, I'm really surprised that 70% of the moms are unhappy.
Yeah, it's a startling fact for us also because we thought that will be a lesser number. But yeah, 70% of Indian moms are unhappy. 41% of the moms also know that they are in an unhappy marriage, you know. So, they were like really startling insights that came out of it. But yeah, the biggest factor that contributes to a mom's happiness is the support from the husband. So, and TJ, what do you have to say how Karunveer has been supportive since you became parents?
I think it's just his attitude towards parenting. He doesn't see that it's a job or it's a responsibility. Yeah. He said, I am also equal partner in making memories with these children. Mm. When they're older, they will not need you. Mm. Then you wish that you had spent more time. And this is such a precious time. I think the first 2 years, you know, build such a strong foundation for the child's self-esteem, for their love. They know that my mom is there for me and my dad. So the dad is not an alien person who just comes in and says, hey, chup chap sojo. You know, he's not there to be a disciplinarian. He's there to also be a parent. And so he's not working. He's parenting. And he's loving it. And you, if you go into that with the attitude that I love this, the babies will feel it also. And that's how it contributes to being a, you know, a happy mom also. Because I don't have to ask, can you help? The help has been there from the start.
And fathers, you know, in general have a lot of roles, you know, when it comes to especially, not only like daughters, even sons. So Karan, what are you doing, you know, to make it right for Bella and Vienna? Do you really, what do you contribute, you know, daily, the daily activities, how do you, what do you
kiss
do?
Them a lot.
kiss them, smothers.
I cuddle them, I smother them till the point of they scream, they shout. I can't help it, man, really, I'm blessed with these two and I'm going to make the most of them. Yeah, seriously.
That's so good to hear, you know, coming from a father. We are already getting a lot of questions. I can see that. Hi, KV, I love your daughters. Oh. They are so cute. I have drawn their sketches also. I
Show
really
me.
Want to meet them, says Yashoda. Yashoda, you can send the sketches.
Hey, there's Namrata Bhaktani Sadwani, who is a fellow twin parent too.
Oh, yay. Wow. Yeah.
Are you happy? That's the question. I hope you're happy. Happy mom. Yeah.
So, can you give some tips to Namrata for raising twins?
Tell your husband, sara kaam chhod ge. No, I'm kidding. You know what?
Enjoy it together.
Really, you know, everybody is not as lucky as me, okay? But whatever time, I'm sure, I know a lot of my friends who are shooting, and they run back home to be with their babies. So they make time, you know? So everybody has to make some time or the other. Everything comes together. You just have to manage it together.
I think, you know, when a lot of people don't have the option, even though they want to be there.
Yeah.
They have to work. But with us, it's because we had kids later on in our marriage. You know, we did a lot of
That's
work
true.
And settling and buy our houses and build our bank balances and do all that. So we're lucky that we can afford to take that time off. And, I don't mean to discount anybody's way of parenting because sometimes not everyone can do that. But on the flip side, they're lucky if they had their children earlier, they got more time with them.
Yeah.
So there's, you know, pros and cons to everything.
Yeah, and of course, you know, in that survey we had questions like, when was the last vacation you took with your husband? So when was the last vacation did you take with your husband alone without
him? We're always on vacation.
Yeah, we are always. So now the good thing is also, her mom is here. Her mom has been here since the kids were born. So like, there's a big nanny factor. And my mom is here too. In fact, my mom was staying in Bandra. We shifted her to another house, which is just in our building as well. So when we want to take off, when we want to do anything, we just tell, you know what?
Give them two babies and say, good
babies.
Luck! And
yeah, take care, we are leaving. So with God's grace, we have such a big help of all the moms.
Mm-hmm.
And now my mom has gone out of the country. So my dad comes, dad, please, you know, manage. We have to go
for a
movie. We have to go out. So my dad is not used to, you know, parenting. Okay? The older generation was never used to parenting. Especially the father, they never had to. So it's a little weird for him.
But it's also... He loves it because he comes home and they both go running like, Dada!
Yeah, so it's the first time actually because all my cousins and kids and nephews and nieces used to get scared of him. These two are the only ones who love him. They get excited.
Them, they're fearless.
Yeah, they get excited. And so he kind of likes it, you know, he wants to be with them. If they want to sleep, he doesn't know how to put them to sleep. So he just sits there.
I can see a lot of questions. Just, you know, people are just saying, I love you. You can see yourself. I love you a lot, KV. I love the videos that you guys post on YouTube.
Thank you.
Blessings to them and kudos to
you. You know, one thing I want to just say about the videos also. Okay. The reason we have this Twin Baby Diaries YouTube page, we just feel that, and the kind of comments we get around 500, 600, 800 comments.
It's amazing.
And everybody says that, you know, we see the videos and we smile.
That's how I fell in love.
You know what I've noticed is that social media has become such a bashing zone.
Yeah.
People who don't have to show themselves make these profiles and they say what they want knowing they'll never be held accountable. So we thought, neither do we ever post any negativity on anybody's account, and neither does anybody post it on ours. And we like that. We like to keep that little happy space, and I think that's why people come to our page. We're not the biggest celebrities. We're not, you know, with modest following, almost 1 million. Some people have 10 million. So.
Yeah.
but, you know, it just, because it's a happy space, people want to come back there, and I think that's what they come
and
for.
It's totally showing, you know, on Insta. I'm getting a comment by Ragini saying, I love Miko, she's so cute, chubby girl, Ragini says. Yeah. And Sushma Tripathi saying, your twins are so cute, Bella and Vienna, we love watching them.
So do
I
we.
I think everybody loves watching
we
them.
We never get tired of it. We see them.
I think you can just eat them up, don't you feel?
What do you think I do every day? Seriously, I was a vegetarian, I got non-vegetarian now. Because of that.
And there is a phenomenon, you know, that you actually end up, you know, people get this mother, especially parents get this, you know, feeling of eating up their babies.
So my nieces, my nephews, they've grown up, now they're big.
Yeah.
But my cousins, they were like small. We should like just kind of really, we have this, Indians have this like smothering nature,
seriously.
You know. This is the mujhe. So I used to tell her, like sometimes, you know, I feel like just, the babies are like few months old, make them straight. Toothpaste and just brush with them, right? That kind of insanity.
So what is the thing that you love doing them on your day off, you know? Say on a Sunday that all of you are at home. What is it that
we are at home every day, firstly. Nothing about a Sunday. Yeah, so the whole process is that they get up in the morning.
And they actually decide.
Yeah.
The
so
morning at 6 in the morning.
Today,
they woke up and like,
yeah, morning.
So
I said,
so
yeah,
happy to get up.
We just put her down and go back to bed. Can she get some?
She's like, Dad, bubbles.
Yeah.
I said, okay, Dad, get up and get the bubbles. Sometimes they want to play on the swings, so we let them play outside. We're like, okay, you guys, let's go outside. We'll play on the swings. So it's a lot of playtime. And a lot of them, we have these little, in the daytime, you can't really go outside because it's too hot. So we have these foam letters and numbers, so we teach them. They know ABCs and they know their numbers. Just because it's with us and it's fun.
Yeah.
So every day we try to give them something different to do.
And now that she's learning really fast, so I think we have a prodigy in our
I want to say that every baby is a lot smarter than you think. This, you know, sometimes it's nice to say oh le and treat them like babies, but they
if you talk to them, if you talk to them like really
adults,
and teach them,
you respect their mind, they understand, they get it.
It's unbelievable.
It's really unbelievable. And it's not just our kids, every baby is so bright.
So sare bacche prodigy paida ho sakte hain, wo hamare upar depend hai.
Yeah,
we are not prodigies, no, we are basically, we don't
speak
love
for yourself, huh?
Yeah. I said it was for me. They would have just been doing all la la la.
So Akriti has an interesting thing to say there. Since you are so active on social media, do you allow such television social media time for your children? How do you plan to be in control with them with regards to technology?
Oh, no TV. So okay, so it's really amazing. Okay, so I have my phone.
We'll record this and post it, and you guys will see.
You will see it how we say. So I just have to show my little one and the other one. I show my phone and say, "What is this?" He said,
No.
So they know not
to touch
this phone.
But they're saying that if you let me, I'll take it.
Yeah. So I keep it out there. They'll go close, and then I look at them, and then go touch it and say, "Oh, no." So you have to train them. You have to actually train them, and even. You know, we give in easily because we want to be free. Like sometimes, khana nahi kha rahe, ek kaam karo, chalo, ye dekh lo, and now eat. So that habit develops like that. You have to actually spend time.
Be very strict.
It's hard.
This is when you have to lay down the rules.
Exactly.
Otherwise, these two little creatures will run all over you.
Every creature. So you have
every
to
be.
Every creature run over you.
You
have to be very strict on yourself also.
We let them on Sundays, we give them 20 minutes of the laptop or tablet. I mean, they're still babies, they want to see something.
Yeah.
So we will give them 20 minutes on a Sunday, And however much they fight, if we say, okay, now you can see, they're like, they'll hold hands, hug each other. They will be on their best behavior because they know they're getting something special.
One more good idea is that you don't have to show them. You can just play the music. That's what we do a lot of times.
Yeah.
They love all these, especially their favorite song, Badri Ki Dulhaniya, by the way. So again, I played it. So they'll, you know, touch us like this and they'll do this. So we know. This means Badri Ki Dulhaniya. So we know that we need to play that song. So we don't show it to them. We play it.
Play it
so,
and they just dance.
So play videos or some cartoons or songs.
Music,
and just,
yeah,
just let them hear it. That's another way of just keeping them, you know, at...
Kirandeep says being parents to twins must be overwhelming, especially
yes.
because I would just like to say something here, because you guys, I mentioned this to TJ also last time, you had really like, you know, a carefree kind of image before you became parents, like no frills
yeah.
attached attitude, I mean young and so full of, you know, doing shows like Khatron Ke Khiladi, and suddenly you became parents and you guys have just transformed,
hey,
you know?
Hey, this is also Khatron Ke Khiladi only,
this is our biggest stunt,
this is the biggest stunt, man. We had two kids and we already killed two kids, boss.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the good thing, nobody there to judge us.
You know, you can, it might look overwhelming from the outside, and if you take it in your mind, like, I'm going crazy, you will. If you just say, it's alright, I got this.
Hey, you
two
know,
little
one,
people, you think I can't handle it.
One more thing,
oh.
I'm sorry to interrupt.
Oh.
Somebody had asked her, how do you manage with these two kids? You know what reply she gave? Man, she stole my heart again.
I do it every day. Huh?
She said, it's not called managing, it's called... raising.
Yeah, wow.
I said, wow. And I looked at her again with another light. Every time there's a new parat that opens up my wife,
oh.
and I fall in love with her again.
It's
again.
So hard being me.
Okay, Akriti says those are good suggestions. Being parents to twins is fit. I think you're just
it's
being
absolutely
fat.
It's
so
fat
please
fat,
don't
yeah.
look at it as managing, okay?
Yeah.
No doubt it is managing your time, but don't call it managing. Call it raising.
Yeah.
And that's what
no,
how we
that's
see
what
it.
You're doing.
Yeah, and what you say, the kind of words you say, those kind of words start infiltrating in your mind and in your vibration also.
Yeah.
And also currently we've also seen you as a doting husband. I mean, you are somebody who's never really shied away from being called your, you know, your wife's husband.
Absolutely.
Especially when I think Canadian Prime Minister Justin
yeah,
Trudeau was
yeah,
there.
Yeah, yeah.
He's
yeah,
my
Prime
Minister-in-law. And I mean, because in that survey we also found out that 80% of the unhappy mom of the happy moms were appreciated by husband, and 44% of the mothers were never appreciated in the 3 months. So appreciation is something which is so like simple, but it's really hard to get when it comes, you know, in people you're dealing
and
with.
I don't
day.
Know why.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
It's as much as if you just women are so easygoing. If you tell, if you come home and you just tell her you're doing a great job. That's enough for her. In the 24 hours, that one little thing it took you 3 seconds to say, we'll cover it. So,
why
don't
you say
hard.
That to me, sweetie? You never said that to me. You've done a great job.
I thank
okay.
you on social media. I thank you at home.
See,
the
life has
thank
become
you.
Social media.
And for the record, thank you. You're a great dad.
Okay.
Next Sunday's Father's Day, I will thank you publicly again.
Okay, and you know one more thing. Okay, see, that's what... And okay, I don't know if all the male who are, or the guys who are watching it right now, okay, remember this, which I always make it a point. What happens, and I've heard it also, that when a child comes into your life, they say, love life is gone, you know, my life is only for the kids, you know. Which I realized, I said, no doubt, life is for the kids. But boss, the wife will always come first. Because the wife is there to love the kids. If the father is there to love the kids first, then who will love the wife?
Something's amazing, yeah.
Who will love me?
Exactly. So, sweetie, I always...
So, five tips from Karan Veer on how to keep wives happy and mothers happy.
Absolutely. Just love your own wife.
There was someone, Alka, had just commented and said...
So, you didn't laugh at my joke.
Love your own wife.
I have to repeat this.
Oh,
double
I'm
joke.
So sorry. I'm so sorry. You know, I'm too used to his jokes, so now I think you need new repertoire. But I was saying, Alka commented and said, I'm having such a tough time with a two-year-old. How do you manage twins? Don't let your baby be the boss of you. Okay? That's why it gets hard.
I want to say that. Hey, one thing. Do you feel daughter is the best gift from God?
Absolutely.
Okay,
yeah.
And Sanjay is asking on Instagram.
Hey, one second, before you start the question about don't let the kids be the boss, okay? It's like riding a horse. The horse knows who's the boss. Either the horse is the boss or the rider is the boss. Wo ek hi hai na jo lagam pakad leta hai na to ghode ko pata chal jata hai.
I know.
Apni lagam thodi tight rakho.
I'm surprised you didn't say that. What a bad horseman horse person I am. First time I rode a horse, he took me to eat grass.
Yeah, he was going wherever he wanted to go. I don't know, what are you doing?
Sanjay on Insta is asking, Nonu Miko, kya kar rahe hai abhi?
They better be sleeping. They should be sleeping. We didn't find out, but yeah, you know, they're chill. Yeah.
Okay, so we have a lot of questions. Do you feel daughters? This we answered. As a parents, KV and TJ are raising Bella and Vienna religiously and traditionally very well. Yeah, this is, I've also seen. Like you said, your their grandmother is with them. You really take out time to go for play dates. You know, spend time with grandparents. What do you feel as a couple, and how important are these traditional values of parenting?
Oh, one more thing.
Yeah.
I would say, yeah, religious, okay, but more spiritual.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever we have a small little mandir,
mm-hmm.
okay, where there's Buddha, there's Lord Buddha there, there is Guru Nanak ji, there's Ganesh ji, there's Shiv ji, everybody, there, Jesus is there, angels are there. Whenever the baby, the passing, they just bow down. They do matha take. Sometimes they will do shashtang also. They do shashtang also. So, you have to, again, it's what the mother eats, drinks, hears, listens when she is pregnant. What she does, even once the babies are out, is exactly what the babies are going to do. So a mom plays a really definite big role, but...
I think, you know, just the world is a different place than we were than when we were growing up. And if you give kids, it doesn't have to be very religious, but a spiritual upbringing, they'll be able to balance their lives when they're a little older. They'll be able to think a little more clearly. They won't be, their minds won't be as hyperactive.
Yeah.
I'm thinking when I can get them started with yoga, you know. So, so it is important. You don't, and neither do we belong to just one specific religion. You know, I think sometimes these rules are too much rules and not enough heart.
Yeah.
So, well, I don't mean to insult anybody's religion.
It's good to be Sanatana Dharma. It's good to love every religion.
Yeah,
be who you are, where you come from, but you need to love every religion, respect every Sari Granthuk. You know, you have to love it.
Yeah, I can see we are still getting a lot of fan comments.
So now
you've
just
lost.
Hi, we see you and we'll get in touch.
Yeah, so we can't really take all of them. We're running out of time, guys. So thank you for joining us. And as they said, you know, parenting is not that difficult. It's simple. Last message from you guys for the readers who are watching.
Last message, all I can say is that, guys, just do your own thing. What do you think is right? Do that. Don't get pressured. Don't get too judgmental. Don't listen. Suno sabki, and whatever you feel is right for your kid, do it.
You know, on Father's Day, we'll do a live on Facebook and Instagram, so stay tuned for that. But we'd just like to say that, you know, we're not anything greater or lesser than anybody else. We're just parents, you know. You'd kind of get children and say, there you go. It's not our responsibility, it's a blessing. So if you keep seeing it that way, once you shift your mind, it becomes a lot easier to take care of them. Even on days when they're screaming, you think, it's all right. You know, there's noise because there's a baby in the house, and that's a big gift.
And I think we'll end with what Pallavi is saying. You guys rock as parents. We believe you rock too. The day you take parenting as a joyous journey, it becomes easy. And that's what they are also saying. Thank you guys for joining us. And keep stay tuned in for the other lives that we'll have in the coming weeks.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Peace out.
It was so good.
That was good.
I was just blabbing.
That was so good. You're natural. You don't need to like look at questions and do this and that.
And,
Sudhi, can we just take a...